Listen, remember, this was 2005. He's doing an interview with Billy Bush of Access Hollywood. Listen to just a snippet here. We'll get to more of it later, but here's just a snippet.
I moved on her very heavily. In fact, I took her out furniture shopping. She wanted to get some furniture. I said, I'll show you where they have some nice furniture. I took her out furniture. I moved on her like a bitch. I couldn't get there, and she was married. And all of a sudden, I see her. She's now got the big phony tits and everything. She's totally changed her look.
I should have at the beginning said what you're some graphic language, and I apologize for not saying that in advance. That's one of the tamest parts. That's one of the tamest parts of this tape here. And the point, if you go on in this tape, that's talking about making unwanted advances on a married woman, and you heard the language in it. If you go on in this tape, and we'll play some of this later, he also talks about conduct that is a crime. If he did it, people go to jail for the things that he was talking about doing and groping women. That was the dam opening.
Yeah, absolutely. And I mean, I think that's why you saw particularly people like Kelly Ayotte and other women in Congress come out so strongly. I mean, there was this irony where, you know, Paul Ryan had signed a bill earlier in the day that was to protect victims of sexual assault. And then, you know, 2 hours later, the Republican Party is having to deal with this. I think that, you know, the fact that it wasn't just those kinds of that locker room talk that we just heard a moment ago, the fact that it was something much closer to, you know, what would be considered a crime is what made it a dividing line for so many people.
That's right. The fact that it's on tape, the fact that he's there joking about it as well. I mean, in many ways, he ends up tonight where he began. If you remember that first debate, some of those first questions from Megyn Kelly were about his comments about women, calling them pigs, calling them dogs. He said it was only Rosie O'Donnell. But now he's in a much more precarious position. Not only have the polls drifted away from him in terms of real constituencies, even working class white voters peeling away some support and going to Hillary Clinton. But I think Maeve is right. It's the specter of sexual assault, right? Him essentially saying that his wealth gives him permission and access.
And saying he's repeatedly done it.
He's got the tic tacs, right? He's sort of preparing for it in that moment.
And in his video released Saturday night after it took his aides hours to convince him this was a big deal, that's important here too. It took them hours to convince him this was a big deal. He doesn't say in the video that I did this.
Right.
He never says I never did this. He's bragging about, I'm going to say it one more time, he's bragging about things that people go to jail for. I've been in a lot of locker rooms. Men say stupid things in locker rooms. Men say inappropriate things in locker rooms. Men do not talk about committing crimes in locker rooms, or if anybody brings it up, the grown-up on the team pushes that guy against the locker room and tells him to shut up.
What?
Well, one of the things that I've really noticed is the difference between the way that men and women are responding to this tape. When I saw it, I thought this confirms a lot of my worst suspicions. It's obviously full of really salty language, and I was looking at the political implications. But when I've spoken to the women who I work with and the women in my life about this, there's a real sense of disgust. And it doesn't just have to do with the fact that this was a crime. It has a sense of, there's a sense of depression that at this particular point in the country's history, that we're still having this kind of nonsense happen.
Well, he says the irony of this. I mean, we were in a year in which there was so much attention focused on the fact that Hillary Clinton was the first female, you know, nominee, and we have had some of the most crass language about women become part of the political discourse in history.
Yeah, he's bringing the gender card in.